not going to talk about what I said I was going to talk about yesterday. Art as an identity. I'm pushing that off later. I've got axioms. I don't follow them. We just keep going. We just keep going. I'm doing whatever I need to do in order to just keep going because I made a routine for myself. The routine was I'm going to post a video every day on this channel, whether I feel like doing it or not. That is the good thing about routines. That is a pro for routines. That's something I will offer as not me telling you to make a routine for yourself, but I am just going to make the case for routines. Now, before I make this case, you should probably know I have never had a routine that has lasted longer than like 2 weeks that I've chosen for myself. Never. I have never successfully followed a routine for like longer than 2 weeks. And I turned out okay. That being said, I do want a routine, wish I had a routine, wish I had implemented a routine earlier, and I see a lot of the benefits of routine, especially in terms of art. So that's what this video is going to be about, okay? I wasn't really feeling like making this video. I wasn't feeling up to the challenge of recording and talking about art. I knew I would mess it up a bunch of times when I tried to talk about it. I think I've tried to record this 5 or 6 times, actually. Each time I messed up in a different way. I said something painfully wrong. Now it was like the 6th time I'm doing this, and I feel like I've sorted out my thoughts on the matter pretty well, and that I could just talk about it now. The routine made me go, okay, well, I have to put out something, so I'll film some stuff, and it'll probably be bad, and I'll just put that up. And I filmed the stuff, and it was bad, and then I was like, all right, I'll film it again. And I'll film it again, and I'll film it again, and I'll film it again. But because I said, okay, I'm just going to film this bad stuff, and I'm going to keep going, now I'm on take number 6. I feel fine about it. I'm getting more energy and more thoughts every time I do it. And it's working out. It's not working out great, but it's better than me quitting. Because that was the desire, you know? Ugh. Why am I doing this? I can make up all these excuses. I already am feeling all this kind of resistance. Why am I talking down to people? Who do you think you are to give any kind of wisdom or advice about anything? And it's like, at a certain point, you gotta be like, actually, in terms of art, I feel like I've been thinking about it my whole life, and so I can talk about it. What if you're wrong? Well, if I'm wrong, then I'll learn from being wrong. That's how it works. You don't learn from not saying anything. That's some basic advice, man. Oh, you're right. And so, I'm here, and I am making a video. And I'm using this moment in time as an example of, like, if you have a routine, if you work 5 minutes a day on something, then that's the path to doing what you want to do more, or, you know, accurately being able to identify with that label you've given yourself. If you're a writer that cannot write for 5 minutes a day, you know, it's a tough place to be. Now, that's the easy routine. Do whatever you want to do artistically for 5 minutes a day. Write for 5 minutes a day if you want to be a writer. Paint for 5 minutes a day if you want to be a painter. Once you take out the easel and you start working, just work for 5 minutes. That advice, however, is a lie. It's bullshit. Because when we give that advice to you, we don't actually expect you. Here's the thing. Here's the magic. Once you work for 4 or 5 minutes, you get into a flow state. And then you'll want to do, like, more work. You'll be like, oh, wow, ooh, I can paint longer and more, get more into this. Work for 30 minutes, work for an hour. I'm not saying that, you know, you need to. If you only work for 5 minutes, that's still a huge win. But the thing is, it's like you're building into your day a huge win, 5 minutes of work. And then you're allowing that huge win to spiral into just win after win after win. Like, that's an enormous victory. And so I tell you this advice with the full knowledge that I have an insurmountable like difficulty following routines. I have not followed routines. And here I am, you know, telling you routines are good. So what's going on there? Well, there's this thing in Myers-Briggs, extroverted intuition versus introverted sensing. It's basically the creativity function is directly opposed to the maintenance stabilizing function. So essentially, routines are directly opposed to ideas. Seems like a weird parallel to make, like a weird dichotomy to make. There are people who have great ideas and great routines. And it kind of feeds into the stereotype that you can't be, you know, you can't be creative and have a good structure to your life. I don't necessarily think that's right, but I do think that there's something there, that if you're more creative, you're probably less likely to be able to be routine oriented, or you're gonna struggle a lot more with routines, or the routines that you have are gonna be like, man, I really don't wanna do this right now. I cannot believe Frank James Myers-Briggs pilled me a little bit. I still think it's mostly bunk. I really like the ocean model way, way better, but there are some aspects of Myers-Briggs I'm like, well, there's something here. Oh God, oh man. All right, anyways, that's painful to admit as well. Routines. Yeah, so here's my half-assed conclusion, okay? Because I'm trying to cobble together like a genuine point at the end of these videos instead of just ending it with some horrifying tension like I normally do. Although I might do that more. That was fun. I like the horrifying tension. But I guess in this point, what I'll say is you're going to try a routine for 5 minutes a day. And when you fail, because you will fail, you're going to have this thought, okay? The thought is going to be, oh God, I'm a fucking fraud. I couldn't even do this for 5 minutes a day. I am a worm. I am the lowliest worm. Oh God, 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 God. You're going to think that exact thought, and then you're going to play a YouTube video to drown out your thoughts. I'm 100% sure that you're going to do that. Now, I want you to know that when I say you, I'm pointing to me on my viewfinder. The way that you work if you don't have a routine is you wait for inspiration to strike. The inspiration strikes you, and then in that moment when you have the inspiration, you sit down and you do everything. So if I have a perfect skit idea, like right now, when it's fresh in my mind, set up everything, put up the green screen, blah, 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 film, edit, post, all in like 4 or 5 hours. It's doable, and you can live like that, and I have lived like that. But, well, you know what? I'm just going to leave the tension. Remember what I said about not leaving tension? There, deal with it. Deal with that tension. I'm giving you advice, but I'm a really bad exemplar for it. So, I guess the point is, you know what? No, no points. You figure it out. You figure it out.